Good afternoon, Onshapers. Jenny here with another Onshape tech tip. There are many options when creating fillets in Onshape. Let's break down the different settings available while creating them. To create a fillet, you use the Fillet tool on the toolbar. There are many options available when creating fillets. You choose an edge or a face that you want to apply the fillet to. You can then choose what type of measurement. We're doing a radius fillet here with a circular cross section. You can adjust the different radii, and this will dimension in a drawing because it still stays as an arc. However, you can stay with a radius profile but change how that cross section looks. So you can do it as a conic or as a curvature. With a conic, you keep the same radius measurement, and we're applying it to this front edge here. And then you can adjust the row value, and you'll see as I do that, we go from an elliptical profile to a parabolic to a hyperbolic. You can also choose a curvature profile, which will try to match the curvature of the faces that you're interacting with. Again, you apply a radius value, and then you can adjust the magnitude for how you'd like that to behave. You can also, instead of applying it as a radius, apply it as a width fillet. And the width is applied across the dimensions from here to here across what the width of that will be. You have the same three settings, circular, in which you can adjust the width of that fillet. You can also do it as a conic. Again, it'll have a width profile and then a row value that'll adjust the shape of that profile. And you can see it changing in here. Or a curvature-based fillet. Zoom back out for you. And you can adjust the magnitude of that based on the curvature that it's trying to meet on those faces. The last option is to apply a variable radius fillet. A variable radius fillet is applied by picking an edge and then choosing, again, your profile's radius, circular, conic, or curvature. We're just doing a simple circular profile here. And then you can choose where you want to change that radius value or that width value. So you can specify different vertices either at the end point of each line, or you can put a point in the middle of a line and you can drag that point a little bit left and a little bit right. You can add another point in and adjust it. So if you really need to fine tune your profiles, you can add those in as well. Lastly, I wanted to show you how dimensioning fillets would work in a 2D drawing. A lot of components with fillets, you send off the 3D model, but if you do need to dimension them, this is how they will dimension. A fillet with a constant radius, you'll be able to dimension that radius as well as the width of that fillet. But if it's a conic fillet or a curvature fillet, you'll only be able to dimension the widths of those fillets. You cannot dimension the arc because it'll become a spline instead of an arc. This is a width fillet. All of them are set at that 0.2, but again, you can set the radius of that and dimension it, but you won't be able to dimension to the radius of either of the profiles. I hope this tip has been helpful for you to get a little bit more insight into the Fillet tool in Onshape.